Hey guys, what's going on? Today I am with my friend Shelby and her boyfriend Captain TJ. TJ runs charters out of Hillsborough Inlet, which is actually the inlet that you guys see us go out of all the time, but he also does charters down in Miami for tarpon. So that's what we're going after today. Shelby's driving the boat right now, and we got TJ up at the front who's looking for some mullet so we can cast them to use as bait. And then we're gonna go out and start fishing, so wish us luck. This whole time, and check out this mangrove I just caught. Absolute stud mangrove snapper.
Any pliers?
There we go. Got it. Check that thing out. Hell yeah. Nice big boy. Pretty cool. These are really good eating. Oh, can I keep them?
Yeah.
Look how big this shrimp is. It's like a little lobster. I feel like I'm in, like you cooked me in a rock. You see that? Like, something cooked me in a rock. Like I'm under a rock.
Do I go for it? Did
you
drag something?
Oh, he's out. Get him. I don't know what this is. It seriously was under a rock. You saw that, right?
Yeah.
What the heck is this? Definitely bigger than the mangrove I just caught.
Is it shaking its head? Is it digging?
Not like digging.
Maybe a big snook, you never know.
The weirdest thing.
Who knows? Could be a creeper.
World record ring.
It's fighting so weird. And now it's just like coming up. Okay, what the heck? Get the net.
It's a redfish, I think.
No, it's a giant cubera or a giant mangrove. Get the net. Oh my god. Oh my god. Or it's a grouper? Is it a grouper?
Yeah, it's a grouper.
I can't tell. No, it's a giant freaking snapper. Or is it a grouper? I can't tell what this is like.
It's a grouper.
No stinking way.
That's awesome.
Wow, that is so epic. No way. What is it? It's a black grouper? A gag?
Yes, a gag.
A gag? I've never caught a big gag grouper before. That was so epic. Wow, he freed me so bad. Look at that. I was about to break off. No way! Can I keep this? Are you looking it up?
Yeah, I can.
Hell yeah, Shelby, that was epic, wasn't it?
They went to Berkeley to catch one species and we never thought we'd catch there.
Right! Look, we can measure them right here. It's on the freaking floor. That was so epic. 30? How big do they have to be?
He's huge.
Bigger than
20 something. 24.
24 for a gag?
Yep.
He's like 31. He was hooked perfect. Can you see that?
Yeah. He took you into a rock before.
He took me into a rock and he was just sitting under the rock. TJ, come on, that was epic.
That's awesome.
Guys, give me some excitement here. I'm like so stoked.
I'm happy. I'm stoked too. I'm tarpon fishing, catching grouper.
Hell yeah. Check that thing out. Alright guys, so we're out here tarpon fishing, trying to catch tarpon and snook, and we got some shrimp for bait, and I'm using a shrimp on bottom, and I just got eaten by something that brought me under what I thought was a rock and cut me off like immediately, and I was like, I don't know what that just was, and I think it might have been this exact same fish. It'll be really cool when we clean him to see if he's got that giant shrimp in his belly. Wouldn't that be cool?
Yeah.
And I was like, I swear it just took me under a rock and broke me off, and then this guy took me under a rock and sat under the rock for like a good 30 seconds and then came out, and I was like, this is fighting so weird. I have no idea what this is. Big gag grouper, so sick. I don't even know if I've ever caught a gag grouper before, to be honest, so hell yeah. Thanks guys.
You're welcome.
Pretty cool.
It looks so sick with the city behind you.
Alright, well TJ said that when you fish with shrimp, you catch a lot of bycatch. I caught a mangrove, caught a gag, and we're fishing for tarpon. Pretty freaking awesome. I'm stoked.
I'm stoked for you.
So cool. What do you think, Shelby? Snapper?
Yeah, I think it's another snapper.
Oh, it's a little grouper! Oh. A little gag. Heck yeah! There you go. Nice.
They're still pretty fish, even when they are little.
Very pretty.
Yeah.
Look at his, oh my gosh, with the lights. His tail is lighting up blue.
It's so blue.
Here, hold it up. Oh, it's lighting up so cool. They are so pretty. These bottom fins are lighting up blue. Look at that. Cool. Can't keep him, but he's pretty.
Yeah.
Captain TJ putting us on the gags tonight. Oh, nice. Alright, let's get you a bigger one. Alright guys, we got something else. Small, but we got it up. Another. Oh, mutton! No freaking way!
We called it, bro.
I called it! I said, how cool would it be if I caught a mutton? I don't think he's legal. He's probably like 16. Hold on. He's probably like 16 inches.
Still a cool catch.
I literally told Shelby earlier, I said, how cool would it be if I caught a mutton here? And look at that. Oh, he's so close. No way, look. They have to be 18, he's like a quarter of an inch away. All right, well, that was really cool. Caught a nice little mutton, look how pretty. These are like the prettiest snapper.
We called it too, that's awesome.
I know, I was like, that would be so cool if I caught a mutton here. All right, he's going home. He's going back to eat some more shrimp. See ya. Alright guys, we are back at the ramp, and yes, we did come out here to catch tarpon, but you know, sometimes you don't get what you're looking for, but I am so stoked about that grouper, you have no idea. I've caught gag grouper before, but never a legal one, and that was a nice one, and that mangrove was big, the mutton was really cool, I had a ton of fun. Shelby and TJ are really awesome people, and Shelby actually is a badass female angler who actually mates for TJ sometimes. And you want to tell them a little bit about your charter business?
Yeah, so we're Flatline Sport Fishing, we're based out of Pompano Beach. Most of our fishing's out of Hillsborough Inlet. We do inshore and offshore. If we're fishing up north out of Pompano, we go offshore. And if you're interested in snook and tarpon trips, we come down to Miami. The best time of year to do all that would be January to the beginning of May.
So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you give us a phone call or find us on Instagram, Flatline Sport Fishing.
And I will have all of his information linked down in the description. And I guess we'll probably come back out here and get on some tarpon on another day. So be looking forward to that video. And I think I'm gonna go home and clean up these fish and cook them up for you guys. So stay tuned for that. See you at the fillet table. All right guys, so while I was fishing with TJ and Shelby, Victor was over on the West Coast and we got a bag with some, I guess this is my mangrove snapper. We got a bag of snook. We got a bag of pompano. And now it's time for me to play my grouper. And tonight we're gonna have a big taco night with 10 people. My aunt and uncle are in town and we're gonna make a bunch of tacos and it's gonna be really delicious. But first we gotta flare this guy up. I'm gonna squirt him off because this guy is super slimy. All right, now grouper, the first side's usually pretty easy to fillet, and then once you get to the second side, it's a little harder because their head is so giant and then they're kind of awkward when they're laying on the fillet table. But I always like starting on this side of the fish, start from the head, work down. Feel up where their head meat is, go around their gill plates, always feel around. And that's when you're gonna start your cutting. Now, I'm very excited to check in his belly if he's got that giant shrimp that I was using. And maybe there was another fish down there that ate my shrimp, but it'll be very interesting to see if this guy's got it in his belly. Okay, so now that I made that cut, I'm gonna take my knife and feel where the backbone is so I can feel, so I know where the backbone is. And then I'm going to just start going down the fish, making sure that my knife is on their bones the whole time. Just like that. Now, a lot of times you guys will see me go like this in a video. That's because I get scales on my knife and I'm like trying to get it off. Okay, so now that I made that first cut, I'm gonna take my knife and just come in here, lifting up with one hand and gliding my knife down the bones with the other. I like to see what I'm doing the whole time. There are some people who are really good at filleting and can just shove their knife in there and whip it out, but I'm not that good. So I like to pick it up and know what I'm doing. So when I'm finished, I'm not surprised if I missed meat or something like that. It's gonna be a nice chunk of fish. Nice fillet. You know, Vic?
I've never had gag grouper, ever. Have you?
I guess I haven't either.
We might have gotten in a restaurant and never known about it, but we've never went out and caught one ourselves.
Yeah, that's what I was saying, that I've caught them before, but I've never caught a legal one before. Okay, so now I'm to the backbone. And groupers have a decent sized backbone, so make sure you're turning your knife down the opposite way.
And big ribs.
Big ribs, which I'm gonna get through now. So now I'm going over the rib bones. I don't wanna go through them, so I'm going over in the rib bones. And again, I'm pulling up with one hand and working my knife with the other. Okay, last cut, cut off the tail. Here we go. You ready? Ta-da! All right, so there is our first half. Big chunk of meat. I think I did pretty darn good, Vic. What do you think?
Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent.
Slow and steady wins the race. So now before I take the other side off, I'm going to show you guys that groupers have cheek meat. Now, if you see this right here, this is where their cheek meat's gonna be. And it's normally kind of a perfect little circle. Now, you're kind of just like following where their bone is. And it's like literally like a nice perfect little circle there. And we got a nice little pretty circle. A lot of people think this is like the best meat of the grouper. I think I missed a little bit closer to his mouth right here. But this is all bone here, so I didn't miss any there. But I think it should have been a little bigger than that. What do you think, Vic?
Not by much.
Now, another thing about groupers is a lot of people make a soup out of their head. I know people make a lot of soup out of a lot of fish. But people make like a grouper soup with their head. I've never done that before. If you guys have done that before, comment down below. Let me know a recipe to do that, because I know people make like a stew, like a soup with a grouper head. Time to do the other side.
I think you should.
Okay. There is our second half. So much meat off of these things. What do you think, Mike?
99% yield. I see the sun shining through it.
Yeah. Okay.
Check for your shrimp.
For the moment we've all been waiting for. Ooh, his belly is full. If he's got my shrimp in there, I'm going to be so excited.
There's a mullet in there.
There's something in there. Wow. That is not a shrimp. What is it? What the
Some
heck is that?
Some wrasse or...
No, that's not a wrasse.
Yeah, it is. Look at its tail.
It's not a wrasse.
Some type of reef fish. Some type of tropical reef fish.
It looks like a pinfish.
No, it's not a pinfish.
Look at its face. It's shaped like a pinfish.
That's not a pinfish tail.
Okay, well, he's got one fish. Another
it's a tropical
one.
Reef fish.
Another one.
That's a trigger fish.
A trigger fish. No way. Look at that. That's so neat.
It's been eaten on the reef.
There's another one.
No way.
Another trigger fish? Look at that. Two trigger fish. How stinking cool. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's all she wrote. No big shrimp. Or my shrimp that I caught it on. So that means that another one stole my big shrimp. I was like, I guarantee that was it, but maybe there was another big guy down there and I didn't get him. How cool. I don't know what this is. If you guys know what this is or have an idea, comment down below. Honestly, it looks like a sergeant major. No?
Uh-uh.
I don't know. Now, I've been saving my grandma a ton of crab bait, so I'm not going to save this one for her for crab bait because it's going to be hard to fit in her trap. So, I always poke fish's eyes before I throw them in the water, or else they'll float because the eyes hold air in them. Now this guy's going for his last swim. I didn't expect to find a trigger fish in there.
Mm-mm.
Who would have thought? Now to flay the fish, I use the Dexter 6-inch Sani Safe, but always to skin a fish, I like a nice, narrow, flexible knife. This is actually a 9-inch narrow fillet knife. I've never used the 9-inch before. I usually use the 7-inch, but this is going to be perfect for this because this fish is so wide. So start at the tail, hold it down with one hand. I'm on the edge of my fillet table. So work your way down. Ta-da! Look at that skin. Huge piece. No meat on there. Okay.
Whoa.
What is it?
I don't know.
Grouper do have pin bones. So find out where the pin bones are. I can feel them all the way up to this point right here. There's that. And this we'll save for crab trap bait. Now there is one of our beautiful grouper fillets ready for the kitchen to be made into tacos. I'll see you guys back in the kitchen. Hey guys, welcome back to the kitchen. So I have my grouper prepared into like chunks about this big, and this is the whole grouper on this plate here. And as I said earlier, we're making tacos, so I'm gonna be making grouper, and Victor's gonna be blackening some snook. And what I have going on here is I have Italian breadcrumbs, and then I have seasoned panko breadcrumbs. So I'm gonna do about half a panko, half an Italian breadcrumbs, and let's get started breading them. So all I'm doing is putting it into plain egg, and then just going straight into the breadcrumbs. You wanna make sure you get a nice solid coating and wait until you guys see what we're gonna pull out and have a giant spread here. We got homemade guac. Victor made homemade guac. He made a homemade salsa. We got bang bang sauce. What else do we have there?
Tortillas, chips.
Yeah, we have a whole thing, and we're gonna have like a whole taco bar going on. So for me, the simplest thing for feeding 10 people is fried fish. You can't go wrong with a nice fried fish. My aunt and uncle are in town from Ohio, and we fished today and we had a long day, so my always go-to is some nice fried fish and blackened fish, so we got the best of both worlds. Make sure you get a nice coat of that panko. I'm gonna finish battering these up and then I'll see you when it's time to fry. So Victor's got his onions for his blackened fish going on over there. We have some black beans back there, and then we have some Spanish rice that we're gonna, Mexican style rice, right out of the box, very authentic. All right, now I got a hot pan with oil. And I'm gonna start putting my fish in. There we go. Smelling good already. I like my fried fish extremely crispy, nice and brown. Just like that. That's what I love, that nice, beautiful golden brown. So Victor's got his blackened snook going on, and now I have the panko fish on, and I'm flipping them, and they got that nice golden brown on them. All right, so here's our spread. We got Victor's blackened snook. He also did some like caramelized onions. Here's my fish. Half is Italian, half is panko. We got some Mexican rice. We got some black beans. Victor's homemade salsa and chips. Victor's homemade guac. And then we got some mixed lettuce, mixed greens, cheese, sour cream, and then this is a bang bang sauce. I think that's it. Time to enjoy and make some tacos.
Much as you can, because we made way too much food.
It
looks amazing.
So what is the difference of the fish?
Start over here, get a plate, and then work your way around.
No, I'm just wondering what kind of fish.
We have a problem.
This is snook. This is snook. This is grouper. This is Italian breadcrumbs. This is panko breadcrumbs.
All right. Which do you recommend?
Everything.
One of each. Wow. Do a blackened taco, do this taco, do one of those.
It's a requirement.
And it smells good.
And these are caramelized onions.
Does the rice go on the taco?
No rules.
Well, oh my gosh,
you got a burrito going on there, not a taco.
He wishes
to be
the big taco. Ooh, yours looks good.
Sauce.
Oh yeah.
guy's gotta be hungry. He just did a Ragnar race.
Starving.
Just
to go inside my thing too. Just lettuce.
Yeah.
I might have to eat my taco open face.
That's definitely the everything taco.
Which one's the blackened?
Snook.
They're both good, but the snook is it's real hard to beat.
Ooh. Cheers, everybody.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Delicious.